Welcome to this speech concerning the exploration of mathematical limits of micromagnetic tomography. Micromagnetic tomography, or MMT, makes it possible to obtain the characteristic remnant magnetization of individual grains by combining a quantum diamond magnetometer, which images the magnetic field, and a micro-CT, which obtains location of individual magnetic grains. This method was successfully used by De Groot and others to obtain the magnetization of individual grains in a synthetically created sample. However, they did not look at the uncertainties of the magnetization solution caused by the Gaussian noise in magnetic field measurements. That's exactly what we try to do in this research. To that end, we run a lot of different numerical models, which differ in grain density, sampling rate, noise level, domain size, and thickness. We start by randomly placing grains with a given magnetization in a model. Then we construct a surface magnetic field and add the appropriate level of noise to it. With the least squares inversion procedure, we obtain the magnetization together with the standard deviation from a covariance matrix, which is dependent on the orientation of the grains. However, the standard deviation is in three directions in the Cartesian coordinate frame, as you can see on the left side. But we want to reduce this to one uncertainty parameter for the sake of easiness. To this end, we choose to construct a confidence sphere around the magnetization vector, as you can see over there. To obtain that, we bootstrap the magnetization vector with the help of the covariance matrix 10,000 times. And then we use these 10,000 vectors to create the 95% confidence sphere, of which 95% of the vectors fall within this sphere. The size of this confidence sphere is then expressed by defining the radius of the sphere by the norm of the magnetization vector times 100%. In this figure, we plotted the size of the confidence spheres on the y-axis against the different grain densities on the x-axis and noise levels in the boxplot figure. Under various conditions, so various sampling intervals and thicknesses of the sample. And we can immediately see that larger noise levels make larger confidence level sizes. So the larger noise, the more worse the solution becomes. We also observe that thicker samples of 75 micrometers perform worse than the thinner samples of 50 micrometers as their confidence level size increases. The last thing we see is that small grain densities have very low confidence level sizes when we compare them to the higher grain densities. Therefore, the smaller grain densities have better solutions. If you want to know more about how to extract grains which still have a proper solution, even though the median is very bad, be sure to visit my poster stand or contact me at f.out@uu.nl. Thank you for listening.